Good evening. I'm Sharon Tazewell.
And I'm Sean Maroney. Thanks for joining us. We have just learned more people in North Carolina now have the Zika virus, and there's a very real possibility of dozens more cases. In response, state health officials are stepping up their efforts to fight the virus, including hiring two more experts. They're also asking you to take extra precautions, especially if you travel to the Caribbean and other parts of the Americas. CBS North Carolina's Justin Quisenberry shows us some key things you need to know.
UNC researchers here say there are five confirmed Zika cases in North Carolina, and they're waiting on test results for 109 pregnant women.
They're not surprising numbers when you consider the large areas of the world that now have active Zika.
UNC researchers are working on how to diagnose Zika so they can think about interventions and detecting it through ultrasounds and how to treat people. In the meantime, these experts say lifestyle factors such as having window screens and air conditioners help limit the possibility of new cases forming here in North Carolina.
I think it's highly unlikely we would see mosquito-borne cases, so it's really going to be returned travelers who acquire disease while they're abroad and then come back ill and we need to take care of them, or the possibility that they would acquire disease and then there would be sexual transmission from infected men to women.
Researchers here are looking at questions such as, is Zika affecting all phases of a pregnancy? How long can a male transmit it? And the hospital is working on its preparedness, expecting to see and follow people who may be infected. In Chapel Hill, Justin Quisenberry, CBS, North Carolina.
And you can learn more about the Zika virus on our website, WNCN.com.